All right, sometimes when you're taking a look at your well, you wanna make sure you look down at the base of the well. So over here, we can see that there are visible holes all along the base of this casing. Generally, when you have a well that is made of metal casing, it's gonna rot out real close to the base of the ground. So every few months, it's always a good idea to come out here as a homeowner and just check and see what's going on. As you're aware, all metal is going to rust, so eventually your well is going to develop pinholes or any kind of larger hole like this one. So whenever you notice that, best practice is to call a local professional, have them dig down, cut to a non-affected portion, and then weld a similar material back up to the surface to the current local code, right? You want to make sure that you use a metal casing on a metal casing instead of using a Fernco with a PVC pipe above. The reason you don't want to use dissimilar material is that you can potentially have thermal expansion at different temperatures. This can allow for bacteria to infiltrate into the well, which can cause problems. We also can see that somebody used the good old Big Blue poly pipe as the conduit. This water line also has Big Blue piping as its main supply line into the house. So we're going to recommend to this client to consider a pipe replacement. Big Blue piping generally was used between the 1970s to 1990s. In public application, there was a recall on it due to the chlorine causing pinhole leaks and damage to it. With a private well system like this, the likelihood of you having chlorine in your well on a continual basis is very low. Generally, whenever you have bacteria in the well, you shock it with chlorine. That little bit of chlorine is not going to cause any permanent damage, but if you were to have a chlorine injector to where it's constantly putting a little bit of chlorine into the well, that's where you could run into some problems. Additionally, you want to make sure that you check out the cap, look at the bolts. As we can see, this one's a little bit older. This well was drilled and installed in 1990, so it's starting to show a little bit signs of its age. We're going to also recommend that when they replaced the casing, that they consider to also replace the well cap with a nice modern vented cap. Whenever you're having your well done, you want to make sure that somebody's a licensed well driller or a master plumber who has had experience working on wells. You do not want to have an unlicensed contractor working on this because this is your drinking source. As always, the EPA recommends to test your water at least once a year for bare minimum of bacteria and nitrates. This one came back clean, even with these gaping holes, but just because it came back clean does not mean that you should do nothing. Eventually, whenever rainwater, bugs, grass clippings, or whatever get into the well, you're gonna run into a bacteria problem. Right now it's raining, and we can see that there's a good old bush of grass getting in there, which can cause some problems. So just make sure you check your well on a regular basis.